In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. God, whose almighty word chaos and darkness heard and took their flight, hear us, we humbly pray, and where the gospel day sheds not its glorious ray, let there be light. Savior, who came to bring on your redeeming wing healing and sight, health to the sick in mind, sight to the inly blind, O now to all mankind, let there be light. Spirit of truth and love, life-giving holy dove, speed on your flight, move on the water's face, bearing up lamp of grace, and in earth's darkest place, let there be light. Holy and blessed Three, glorious Trinity, wisdom, love, and might, boundless as ocean tide, rolling in fullest pride, through the world far and wide, let there be light. My dear friends, in the liturgy of the Word of God today, particularly in the Gospel, we see Jesus teaching his apostles to pray. In the Gospel, very especially Gospel of Luke and Mark, we see Jesus spending early morning when it was still dark, and he would spend the time in prayer. When we were in the seminary, the retreat preacher asked us to get up at 5 o'clock for the morning prayer. One of the brother replied, "Father, why should we get up early morning at 5 o'clock? Where is it written that Jesus got up at 5 o'clock and prayed?" Immediately the preacher said, "Take the Gospel of Mark chapter 1 verse 35 and read." And it read like this: "Early in the morning when it was still dark, Jesus got up and went to a lonely place and he prayed there." So from that day onwards, we had no option than to get up at 5 o'clock for prayer. My dear friends, Jesus does not give a formula. He does not give a treatise on prayer. Rather, in a very simple term, just as a babe talking to his father, the Lord teaches his apostles to pray. There's no greater theology or philosophy of prayer. In prayer, as Mahatma Gandhi says, it is better to have a heart without words than words without heart. Therefore, our Lord calls upon in prayer to establish a relationship with the Heavenly Father. Therefore, as Little Flowers in Tears of Child Jesus says, to pray is to love. Therefore, our Blessed Lord teaches us to begin the prayer with the establishment of the relationship of love, our Father. It is not a selfish, egoistic term, my Father. It is our Father. Therefore, prayer encompasses our own limitations of selfishness and ego towards universal brotherhood, as the whole world as one family, Vasudeva Kutumbakam. Therefore, we pray on behalf of all those who even do not pray. We pray on behalf of all those who do not even believe in God, because they are also the sons and daughters of God. Therefore, the Lord invites us to establish a loving relationship with the Father. In a book written by a Muslim convert to Christianity, the title of the book is "I Dare to Call Him Father." Because she realized, how can God be a father? And when she realized that God can be a loving father, and she was liberated in her understanding about God, and that very word, one term of father, made her such an impact in her life, so that she embraced Catholicism. My dear friends, to pray is to love. And if we love, we have to love one another, because we are all sons and daughters of the same Father. Therefore, to pray is not just to finish some verses or lyrics and then, or finish your obligation on Sunday, or come back, or say the rosary. To pray is to allow God to transform us, to challenge us, to live as His sons and daughters. If I call that God as the Father, and if we together say our Father, how can I do injustice? How can I do harm? How can I do the backbiting? How can I do the gossiping? How can I spoil the good name of the other? Never. If we do that and once again come and pray our Father, then we are lying about the Father. We are not praying to the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, but we are praying to our own fathers. My dear friends, that is the challenge this simple prayer teaches us: to establish a loving relationship with the Father and with one another. So therefore, prayer as a vertical dimension of connecting to the Father, plus horizontal dimension of connecting to one another. Therefore, prayer is the armor with which we experience the power of God here on earth. Therefore, let us meaningfully and let us live this prayer. One of the ways the early church fathers prayed was to pray every word Some of them said, "It takes me one full day to pray meaningfully, Our Father, word by word, meaning, meditating, allowing that word to touch and transform me, challenge me." Therefore, some great saint took one full day, perhaps some months together, to pray one Our Father. That is the depth of the prayer with Our Father. Let us then, as we pray, recite this prayer. Let us ask our Heavenly Father to remove from our hearts ego, selfishness, pride, jealousy, anger, so that we may always live together in brotherhood, glorifying God as His sons and daughters. Towards this grace, let us pray. We pray this Our Father in Latin, Pater Noster.
Pater Noster, qui es in celis, sanctificetur nomen tuum, adveniat regnum tuum, fiat voluntas tua, sicut in cielo et in terra. Panem nostrum quotidianum da nobis hodie, et dimitte nobis debita nostra, sicut et nos dimittimus debitoribus nostris, et ne nos inducas in tentationem, sed libera nos a malo.
Let us pray. Jesus, we thank you for the living relationship you invite us to be the sons and daughters of the Father. Give us that mind and understanding so that as we call God as our Father, may we live here on earth as brothers and sisters, glorifying your holy name and by strengthening by your living bread, so that we may seek your kingdom, so that we may learn to live in fellowship, building the kingdom and kingdom where you are in the center of our lives. We make this prayer in your holy name, dear Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen.